If you're like me and you own an old car, you've probably had this experience. You're driving down the road and you see that dreaded check engine light. You may be thinking, okay, this is bad news. I'm gonna need a tow truck, maybe have a repair. And you might be right, but imagine that same scenario where you didn't have that alert to the problem and you just kept driving. What would happen? You have smoke blowing out the back, you'd potentially need a tow truck and have an even more expensive repair. That same sort of analogy applies to SRE golden signals. Their purpose is to alert you to a problem before it becomes serious. Let's go ahead and put a formal definition behind these. Now, these are for your microservice applications, and the first metric that you're looking for is called latency. That refers to the time between when you make a request and you actually get a response. So for example, with a web application, it might be 200 to 400 milliseconds, and for an API call, it could be a fraction of that, say 20 milliseconds. The next metric is errors. Now errors happen, that's a normal thing. But if there's too many, if there's a sudden spike, it can indicate a problem. Plus also you have to keep in mind that not all errors are created equal. For example, a 500 error where the server's down is much more serious than, say, a 400 error, which means you could simply retry and potentially the problem will resolve itself. T is for traffic. Traffic refers to the amount of requests coming in versus your expectations. And finally, S for saturation. Saturation is the actual load versus your expected capacity. You could think of it as the tachometer on your car. It has a red line, and when it's oversaturated, you're receiving more requests than you can really handle. So now with that definition out of the way, let's look at an example of a microservices architecture. Example, application. And we have several web apps running on a public cloud. And they're talking to a back-end service. The back-end service, in turn, relies on another microservice to handle authentication. The back-end service uses a transaction service to get the information that's been requested by the user, and it, in turn, relies on a data microservices, which might be wrapping a database like DB2 or MySQL. The idea is these boxes here are wrappers of specific services for microservices, and the user of that doesn't have to concern themselves with the underlying implementation. Now, from an ops and DevOps perspective, there are trade-offs to consider. For developers, they really like microservices because it allows them to choose the best technology. That's because microservices has encapsulated all the implementation and they simply have an API. On the other hand, more technology choices means that you have more need for expertise on the ops team to be able to diagnose, pull logs, and find out what is the root cause. The dev team likes that you can have microservices with more frequent deployments. That means that they can deploy on a schedule that is convenient for their development schedule versus a production schedule. But that means potentially more change the ops team has to be aware of. Now, change isn't a bad thing inherently. It could be that their more frequent changes are smaller, and thus when you have to diagnose a problem, it actually becomes easier. So now let's go through and use the four golden signals, SRE golden signals, to diagnose a potential problem. So say, for example, your end users are reporting response time errors. That, in SRE golden signals term, is a latency error. So you look for these services that it's immediately dependent upon, and you find that these two are all within specification for latency errors, traffic, and saturation. However, the transaction service is reporting latency and error problems. And going a little bit further down the line, you see the data service is reporting that it's oversaturated. So in just by monitoring these four different signals, you're able to isolate the potential cause and get to the root cause more quickly. But to do that in a more organized fashion, you can use what's called an APM dashboard, or Application Program Management. That dashboard includes views that encapsulate the four SRE golden signals. And the ops team can use that to monitor problems and be able to address them before they become more serious. But they're not limited to that. For example, the dev team could have their own custom dashboards just for their services. And so when they have a problem, they may potentially even know about it before the ops team is reporting a problem. And that ultimately can mean that you drive down your mean time to resolution and find your root cause faster. Or in terms of a car, that means users will see less check engine lights.